يجب هذا قيمان ما قيمان له قرب أقول عليه
Now, into an area which is prohibited for the lady, where we kept the skulls and the shrines of the ancestors are kept. You may wonder that the peoples are not keeping the shrines and skulls in order, but peoples are now migrated and civilized, therefore areas skulls are not proper arranged. But it happens that if we have to rebuild the cultural values, then we have to rearrange them back in order. But though peoples are migrated and civilized, yet we still keep the values of, and norms of our ancestors. People from the mainland, they have been brought out from here. Just 60 and 70 people start to migrate and civilize.
Last moment, we do it. This is during the time this commissioner from give direction to the aeroplanes, these Americans, because when the aeroplanes flew over this island, and so the village are so happy, they wave their hands. So maybe wrong information given to the Americans, and so the Americans give bombs out.
On behalf of the ancestral values, you are now free to enter this sanctuary. But inside the sanctuary, it has a three apartments. The first apartment where the shrines and the ancestral sacrifice has been done. So you can see here in the front of it, the altars of burning incense. And then the second apartment where the priest usually sleeps. And then the third apartment, called the most holy place, where we kept the skulls of the ancestors. It combines of nine different descendant genealogies. They all have all migrated from inland Malaya. The body has to be stay with the communities, and then before it goes for the burial, the body has to be brought into the front of this house, and then election well has to be done, and not the election shall not done by a live person. A miracle has to happen on that particular day before the dead body has to be moved to the tomb. But before the body move, they have to pass one after the other to touch the body of a dead patient. If a miracle happens to a patient that they have been passed one by one to the oven, then he has to understand that he has to replace the priest. And then later, before the body has to move to the tomb. And then when the body has to be lived in the tomb, usually for 6 days. And after 6 days, the one has to replace and manage the skulls, has to then a ceremony of sacrifice to the ancestors, notifying the ancestors that the one has been managing you are now come to join you, then before the skull has to be moved into the house. Two entities, chiefs are different and priests are different. So each priest has its own descendants. All now civilized. But though they civilized yet, they still believe on the ancestral values. According to the chronological order of the descendant history, 17 to 19 generation old, the skulls there. But problems has been affected since 1942. The World War been burned. The effect of the World War has been damaged. Other skulls, only few skulls has been remained.
Yeah.
We renovate this building, then Tom will arrange them on behalf of his father, because his father is the one who usually bring those skulls. And during the time of Mauma, or the feast, those descendants from here were intermarried. They will bring, each one will bring its pig. Mm-hmm. And that will, he's from here, she's from here.
Not only happened during time of Mom, during time of renovation of the house, mm-hmm. the same process has to be done with this cow. Why?
Because if they stay with the one that receiving thanksgiving and sacrifice, then they have to make walls between them. Why you receive a gift and why we don't receive a gift? If that happens, then they will make problems will be occurred to the descendants. So therefore, the head of the priest has to put them aside. No. But it doesn't mean that they will live forever.
Oi, pali mesi aro.
Ko kamero.
Oh, tara ko ka areta. Ani hul mamatay. Ko ka are lata.
Ara, rata biogo tituata.
Apa? Eh, kada tuwi ne.
Ta. Maneta wo.
Kung lawa ka, hindi mo
Yeah. Okay, during the time of the feast, this priest they will take three pigs.
The preservation of those things. Okay, these ones here, these are the heads of that priest, the priest, and the ones there. As I said, this house is responsible for the finance of this village. This thing, the ceremony which the most valuable ceremony that they usually offer sacrifices to the god responsible before the working of the ceremony.
During the time of feast, those cows, they remove them from those ancestral houses and they will place them here.
Yeah.
And when they place them here, they will this. Dancers will entertain them during the time of a feast.
But this island, it's a man-made island, but we believe on these values, therefore we have system. If we are matter it not that the values, then something will be happening, the matters will be happening to us. Because how can a man exist when he is living on an artificial island, and how can it exist? But according to our traditional values, we believe. And then the ancestral give us, recalls and so for survive.
We want to grow that one to cooking the food for the woman to, after that they stay there. She will be making a status from the woman, they will be stayed there.
But these ceremonies every day.
Oh, God.
go get the respective body where he is shown the reopening of Laulasi tourism industry. Go get the way stand up on our side here. Those where got stand the other side are seven representative from tribal that exist, tribes that exist in our island. And the group here are the interim committee that will manage the operation of the reopening. This is the interim committee. On behalf of our people, we make this official opening where we demonstrate in the cultural activities to tell the people ogeta we ogeta heherem lulasi osem hemi one world cultural place, a historical place where hemi show the heritage of Langlanga Legun. Now Lulasi now hemi show now a new phase of reopening this tourism industry for the years to come.